Okay, so very importantly, we have discussed about the data link layer is going to deal with the framing. And in that particular framing, we have seen four different types of techniques. One is the character count, another one is the character stuffing, another one is the bit stuffing, and this is the another one, physical layer coding violations. Okay, this is not that, but whereas I have told that these three you can implement in your lab part. Okay, and the experiment also, which I have already explained all these techniques and I have forwarded to you. Okay, so now the point is, in the character count, what happened? If there exists a problem, okay, so the count can possibly be misrepresented by a transmission error. Okay, as we have seen that when there is a 5 is there, actually during the transmission, now it is changed to 7. Now what happened at the receiver end? Now this 5, when it is going to mispresent it as 7, then the ordering is going to be changed. According to this ordering changed, now the frames are going to be in the out of synchronization, and then it is not in a position to find out where exactly the frame is going to start, and it is not in a position to inform back to the sender, okay, where it got an error and all. So due to that particular thing, we have moved to the character stuffing. So in the character stuffing, what we said, either you can use one escape character on that. And here, what we are going to do, so normally every frame, we are going to identify the start and end of that particular frame by using a flag. Okay, so every frame is going to have a starting flag and a ending flag. Okay, so now based on that, we are going to say that, okay, so this is what exactly is going to be happen. So starting a flag is nothing but I'm going to say that, okay, so here the frame is starting and here the frame is ending based upon the flag. But the concept is like that. So in middle, there may exist the same flag in your data payload. So in that particular situation, what we said, whenever you are going to encounter that, before that particular thing to identify, you can use escape flag. Okay, so a delimiter, we are going to use that as a. So now here, if suppose escape is also there, you are going to use escape again. Okay, so this is what we have discussed in that particular thing. Okay, see, now this is something like that. Okay, we are going to use a flag and we are going to use a flag to identify the start and end. So now that is what exactly I'm mentioning that. So here, if this flag is encountered in the data, then you are going to keep a escape delimiter field over there. Okay, so if suppose just a moment. Hello. So good morning. IP7 17.7R. Okay. Yeah, so now here, whenever the flag is encountered in the data, okay, so now here the flag, it will come, then this is the end of the frame it is going to think. So to overcome that, what we are going to use escape. Okay, now you will ask that, sir, if the same escape is going to encounter in the data, then again you can keep a escape. Now, so we are adding the extra 2 bytes in your data, okay, and at the receiver end, which is going to be unstuffed, and your original data is going to be retained same, and it is going to be given that. And here, this flag is going to be treated as starting and ending of the flag. But here, what is going to be happening? In the sense, this is we are going to take and we are going to add the bytes. Instead of that, bit stuffing, which we have discussed that, okay, in the bit stuffing, what we are doing in the sense, whenever, so in the bit stuffing, what we are going to do in the sense, we are going to take flag as 0, 6 ones, okay, 0, 6 ones, okay, and 0. Okay, so this is what exactly which we are going to talk about. 0, 6 ones, 0 is a pattern which we are going to take, and whenever in your data consecutive 5 ones are going to be encountered, you have to stuff a one bit called zero, and these zero bits are going to be removed at the receiver end. So now here, if you are going to look at that, bit stuffing is the process of adding one extra zero whenever there is a five consecutive ones follow a zero in the data, so that the receiver does not mistake the pattern. Okay, so now that is what exactly we are going to do the things. Okay, whenever there is a consecutive five ones, but actually what we need, 0 6 ones, but instead of that we are breaking that particular thing with this particular notation by stuffing one bit. Now this is what we have discussed about the bit stuffing. Now here, if you are going to look at the example, now here we are stuffing the things. Okay, so here five ones are there, here also five ones are there, we are stuffing the extra bit so that the pattern is broken, and then we are sending it, and at the upper layer, and what it is going to happen, so it is going to unstuff those bits, and then it is going to give the original data to the upper layer. Now dear friends, what exactly we need? So why we are doing this, so where the frame is starting and where the frame is ending, so for that particular thing we are going to use this technique. Now, but at the same time, when you are sending it, so now you are going to ask me a question that, so sir, during the transmission, if these bits are getting error, imagine if the bit is getting error, so now that is what exactly, so our next concept is flow and error control. So dear friends, now here we have discussed this particular part, and now here today we are going to start discussing about error control. Please put the heading error control. Okay, so is it visible to everyone? I'm asking everyone, is it visible?
Yes sir, it's visible.
Okay, so now here, when we are talking about the error control, let us consider, imagine I am sending a 4 bits. Okay, I am sending the 4 bits. Okay, 0 1 1 0, receiver is received 0 0 1 1. So I have sent how many bits? 4 bits. Receiver received how many bits? 4 bits. Now is it okay or there is any problem?
The order of the bits is different, sir.
I cannot say order of the bits, because whatever the data you are going to send, that data is going to be represented only in the zeros and ones.
The sequence will be changed, sir. Ultimate
no, whether the sender has sent these 4 bits or not. See, it knows that, okay, it is sending 4 bits and it is receiving the 4 bits. Now the point is, so far what we have done, in the sense, only we have solved the problem of making the starting and ending of the frame. But when we are looking at the next frame, next one, so how to make sure all frames are eventually delivered to the network layer at the destination and in the proper order. Now what you are talking about, the order of the bits were different, because now network is unreliable. Now all these bits are traveled in a different routes, or whatever it may be, if it is reaching to the destination in a different order or whatever it may be, but may not be correct. Now, so here in this particular situation, now what we need to identify whether the received data is correct or not, whether the received information is correct or not. Okay, so that is nothing but, now here, see, the receiver can tell whether the frame that it receives contain correct or faulty information. So how we are going to do that? Okay, how we are going to do that? Now here, if you are going to look at that, we need to add some other extra redundancy information to test or to find whether it is correct or not, whether it is correct or not. Okay, so now for that particular error correction, okay, we will come back to the flow control again. Okay, anyhow, we will let me explain. Now here, if we are going to look at that, the most important responsibilities of data link layer is flow control and error control. What exactly the flow control is going to send? So it is going to say that the fast sender, see here I am going to write, fast sender can be forced to reduce its speed. Okay. Now the point is, in the technical way, when we are going to discuss about this, what we are going to talk about is a fast sender cannot swamp the slow receiver. Okay, means if a receiver is able to receive only 10 bits per second and the sender is sending 50 bits per second, now what is going to be happen? The 40 bits are going to be wasted. Now that is what exactly the things. Then we are going to talk about the error control. Now the error control is going to tell us, okay, error control is supposed to say that it is it is a technique to verify the received data. Received data is correct or not. Okay, so this is what exactly which we are going to talk about, the error control. Now these two are the major important functionalities of your data link layer. So when we are going to look at that, now that is the reason. Now here you can have a look at that. Flow control refers to set of procedures used to restrict the amount of data that the sender can send before waiting for an acknowledgement. Okay, now the point is, if I'm sending some data, it has to wait for the acknowledgement. So now how much data it can send before it is going to receive the acknowledgement. Okay, here if I am going to say that sender and receiver, now if sender is going to send, okay, so how much data it can send and all the agreements which we are going to do over here in the flow control. We are going to have a lot of other techniques which we are going to look at that. Now when we are going to look at the error control, which is going to be happening, that whenever there is a error is there, either it should say that it should be retransmitted again, whichever the frame is not received correctly, that has to be resent it, that has to be retransmitted. Now you imagine, okay, suppose imagine the sender is sending 1, 2, 3 frames to receiver. Okay, now receiver is sending the acknowledgement for one. Okay, I'm going to write that ACK 1, ACK 3 it is sending. Okay, it is sending acknowledgement for 1, acknowledgement for 3. Now what is the meaning of this? So receiver has received the frame 1. Okay, it has received acknowledgement, that is nothing but it is received correctly. Acknowledgement 3 is nothing but, so third frame is received correctly. Now which one is not received perfectly? Second one. So now the point is, the second one, it is not going to send the acknowledgement. Whenever it is not going to send the acknowledgement, we are going to call it as ARQ techniques, automatic repeat request. This is a very important question you are going to have in your exam. Automatic repeat request, and which what it will do in the sense, it will retransmit based on that. Now what sender will do in the sense, sender will resend the second frame to the receiver. Now you may ask that, sir, how many times it is going to send? So until it is going to receive the correct acknowledgement for the 2, it is going to retransmit that particular data. Okay, now we will see that how many times it has to retransmit the data and all. So now we will look at the error control. Okay, so now all these things we are going to happen, it is going to be happened by using the protocols. Okay, now according to your textbook flow, we will see what is we are going to have first. Error detection and correction is there, then we are going to have flow control. Okay, no problem, we will discuss with the flow control and then we will come back to the error control. That's not a problem. Okay. So now, okay, put the heading flow control, we will come back to the, okay, we will go in a sequence. So now when it has to be retransmitted, when it should not be retransmitted, when I need a acknowledgement, when I should not need a acknowledgement, and all these things are going to be implemented by using protocols. Now here, if you are going to look at that, this is a very important question definitely in your exam. Okay, from this unit. So now when you are going to look at that, we can combine the framing, flow control and error control to achieve the delivery of data from one node to another. Now we need to have framing, we need to have flow control, we need to have error control. Okay, we will come back to this error control later. So now we are going to discuss this. Okay, so flow control, which we are going to discuss now. Okay, so when we are going to look at that, already framing is completed, we are coming in the sequence only. Okay, so now the protocols are normally implemented in software by using one of the common programming language, whether you take C, C++, Java, whatever the things which you are going to take, that does not matter, because you have to develop these particular programs also in your lab. Okay, so now, which is a language free, as I am mentioning that. So now we are going to look at some pseudocode, how you can write for these protocols, each protocol. Now we will come back to that protocol. So dear friends, immediately, what are the flow control techniques we are going to have? Please note down that taxonomy of flow control, flow control protocols, note down. So we are going to have two different types of channels. We are going to have one is noiseless channel and another one is noisy channel. Okay, so now here we are going to discuss about the flow control protocols. Flow control protocols. So for noiseless channel and for noisy channel, now you tell me, in the noiseless channel, anyone can please respond, in the noiseless channel, whether we can expect any noise? What happened? No one has responded. In a noiseless channel, can we expect any noise?
Sir, not some, maybe the dinosaur.
See, I am telling that the name itself is suggesting that. What is that?
Noiseless.
Noiseless. That is nothing but there will not be any noise. So when there is no noise, whether there is any error during the transmission? No, you will not have any error during the transmission. So we are dividing the channels into noiseless and noisy. But in the noisy, what is going to be happen during the transmission? During the transmission, there may be a noise. Okay, there may be a noise. Due to the noise, your data may be changed. In that change, whenever there is a change, so whatever you are going to receive, so that may not be a proper, then it has to be retransmitted. Now when it has to be retransmitted, that techniques we are going to call it as ARQ. Now that is the reason. Now here, if you are going to look at that ARQ, what is ARQ? Automatic repeat request. What is ARQ? Automatic repeat request. Okay, so now dear friends, now how many protocols we are going to look at that? This is one, this is two, three, four, five. So five protocols which we are going to look at now, five algorithms. Shall we go with the first one, noiseless channel? Shall we look at the noiseless channel?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now easily you can understand that. You please try to understand the noiseless channel. First, assume we have an ideal channel in which no frames are lost, duplicated or corrupted. Noiseless. In the noiseless, you are not going to have any problem. So whatever the frames you are going to send, no frames are lost, duplicated or corrupted. So for this particular channel, two protocols we are going to use for this type of channel. What are those two protocols? Simplest protocol and stop and wait protocol. Simplest protocol and stop and wait protocol. Now, which one we are going to look at now first? Which one we are going to discuss now?
So, simplest protocol.
Absolutely. Everybody is ready. See, I am very unhappy. Everybody has to respond. 536.
Yes, sir.
I'm not responding with this much time. 516 others.
Sir.
516 others.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, listening. You are listening to the class. Others. You have to respond
yes,
then.
Sir.
Everyone
listening,
has
sir.
To respond. Yeah, please. Okay. So now look at each and every protocol. If anywhere any doubt, you have to ask me. Okay. So the simplest protocol. Now the simplest protocol. I'm reducing little size so that easily you can understand. Okay. So in the simplest protocol, now what is going to be happen? So
yes,
now
sir.
From the network layer, you are going to get the data. Data link layer is going to get the data from the network layer. Then it is going to give it to the physical layer. Now physical layer is going to send your frame. Okay. Your data frames. Now when it has to send, whenever there is a request from network layer, whenever there is a request from network layer, your data link layer has to invoke the algorithm. It should invoke the algorithm. Okay. Then it should get the data, create a frame, then send the frame. Now this is supposed to be happen. And at the receiver side, what it should happen? Whenever there is a notification, from the physical layer, arrival of these frames, then immediately your algorithm should invoke and it should collect the frames. Then it should give the data to the network layer. Okay, it should give the data to the network layer. So this should be happened like this. Now, when we are going to look at that, in this one, whether your sender is sending continuously or whether it is waiting for acknowledgement. Now here, I need not require any acknowledgement because this is a noiseless channel which we are discussing about that. In the noiseless channel, whether there is any corruption? No. Whether any loss? No. Whatever I'm sending, it is going to reach in the same order. So now that is the reason it is going to be happening. Now this is the simplest protocol. So whenever sender has anything data to send, whenever it is getting a notification from the network layer, immediately it has to transfer it to the receiver. Now here, if you are going to look at that, how it is going to be happen at sender side. Now you can have a look at that sender side algorithm. While true, that is nothing but it is going to be repeated forever. Now it will wait for the event, sleep until an event occurs. Whenever a network layer is having a data to send it, whenever there is an event request to send, that is nothing but there is a packet to send from the network layer, immediately what it will do, it should get the data, create a frame, then send the frame. Now here you look at get the frame, get the data, make a frame, send the frame. Get data, make frame, send frame. Now whenever it is sending the frame, whenever it is sending the frame, now at receiver end, what it is supposed to do, it should wait for the arrival notification. Okay, so it is waiting for the event. Now whenever the arrival notification is there, what it should do? Receive frame, extract data and deliver data. Okay, receiving the frame, after receiving the frame, from that it has to extract the data packet and then so that has to be delivered to the network layer. Okay, so any doubts in this? Please once again go through with that. Which one I should show? Diagram, this one or algorithm? Everyone, please note down this. Simplest protocol.
Hello. Sir, in class lo unnanandi malli cheyara. After 11:30.
Yeah, I'm asking everyone. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, sir.
So in the simplest protocol, we are not going to see in the simplest protocol, sender is not going to wait for anything. Okay. So from the receiver end, it is not going to even verify with the receiver whether you have received it or not. Whatever it has to send it, it is sent it. Now the second protocol which we are going to look at is the same. Now this is an example. Look at the example. Now here Communication using this protocol is very simple. The sender sends sequence of frames without even thinking about the receiver. That's what I explained. So to send three frames, three events occur at the sender side, and there three events at the receiver side. So note that data frames are shown in tilted boxes, and the height of the box defines the transmission time difference between the first bit and the last bit in the frame. So example here, if you are going to look at that, now this is a sender, this is a receiver. Now sender is sending the frame one, whenever it is having frame two, whenever it is having the frame three, sequentially, whenever there is a request, it is getting the data, it is sending it, and it is sending it to the receiver. And at the receiver side, arrival notification, it is going to be happen. So either you can draw this particular diagram too in that particular explanation of simplest protocol. Okay, now then next one is the stop and wait. So in the stop and wait, now here if you are going to look at the diagram, previously I have sent all the data frames one by one, but here you cannot send. You have to send one, then stop, then wait for the acknowledgement. Wait for the acknowledgement whether the receiver received correct or not. Okay, so now here if you are going to look at, you are not waiting for anything, directly you are sending all. But in the second one, stop and wait, what you are doing? So you are sending one frames first, okay, and then you are waiting it. So here what is going to be happen, whenever there is a event occurred from the network layer, okay, that is nothing but request from network layer, then your algorithm has to do that, and then so it is going to send it to the receiver. Now receiver, whenever notification is there, here it is going to be happen, and it has to generate the acknowledgement. It should go send, resend it. Now this is a difference over here, you see. This is a difference from previous protocol to this protocol. Now here it is going to arrive the notification from the physical layer, that is this acknowledgement. Then only it is going to do that. Now everybody, if you have noted down, then I will explain the algorithm. If you have noted down, I will explain the algorithm. Tell me, shall I?
Yes, sir. I think we can start with the algorithm.
Okay, fine. So now here, if you are going to look at the difference between the simplest and stop and wait protocol, okay, at sender side, initially it is true. Now I am going to say that can send is true. Can send is one of the boolean variable to verify the true and false. Initially I am allowing the sender to send one particular frame, then it should be changed to false so that it cannot send until and unless it is going to receive the acknowledgement for that frame. That was the reason. Initially I am keeping that allow the first frame to go. So I have kept it as true. Then it is waiting for the event. Whenever there is a request to send and can send, whenever the network layer is having a data to send, and whenever it is, this is can send is true. Okay. Whenever these two are true, then what I should do? I should get the data, make a frame, send the frame. Now, after sending the frame, now sender cannot send anything. It has to wait for the acknowledgement. So I am changing the can send to false. I am changing the can send to false. Now that is nothing but cannot send until acknowledgement arrives for this particular frame. Until acknowledgement receives for this particular frame. Now, so after sending over here, now where it should go? Receiving side. Okay. Now we will come back. So at the receiver side, what is going to be happen while true? Arrival notification, it is waiting for the event, and arrival notification is there. What it is going to do immediately in the arrival notification, it has to do receive frame, extract data, deliver data. Okay, receive frame, extract the data, deliver the data. Up to this is same like a simplest, but now what it should do, once if it is received, it has to send the acknowledgement frame. What it has to send? It has to send the acknowledgement frame. So whenever acknowledgement frame is there, now it is going to come. So it is waiting for the event, because can send is false, it cannot send again. So it is waiting for the event. Now, whenever an acknowledgement has arrived, that is nothing but arrival notification. What it is going to do? It will take the receiver frame and then consent is true. Now, whenever consent is true and whenever again a request to send a notification, then again it will send it. Now, this is the algorithm for the sender and the receiver. So, now here if you are going to look at, so this is the algorithm, how it is going to work. Any doubts in this? Dear students, any doubts?
No, sir.
See, any doubts in okay, so very good. So now here when we are going to look at the diagram by taking one simple example. Now here if you are going to look at that simple example, the sender sends the one frame and wait for feedback from the receiver. When the acknowledgement arrives, then the sender send next frame. Okay, note that sending two frames in the protocol involves the sender in four events and the receiver in two events. Okay, because sender has to send two frames and two acknowledgements. Okay, so that is the reason. Now here if you are going to look at that, now sender is involved, receiver is involved only two. Okay, but sender is involved in 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so that is what exactly I have explained. So sender has to send one frame. Okay, then it should wait for the acknowledgement, then it should send the frame, it should receive the acknowledgement. This is what exactly a basic stop and wait protocol. You can draw this particular diagram and you can keep it with you, okay, in your material, please. No doubt. So now, but the question arises, this is noiseless channel, this is noiseless channel, but if it is a noisy channel, then if it is a noisy channel, if it is a noisy channel, then how we are going to do that? Okay, so in the noisy channel, what can happen? So now you imagine this frame may last, or this acknowledgement may not receive it. See, frame has reached to the receiver, receiver has sent the acknowledgement, and this acknowledgement is not arrived. Now what is going to be happen? Okay, let us consider sender has sent the frame and frame has not reached to the receiver. What is going to be happen? Now, for that particular thing, please go through with that. Now we are going to discuss the noisy channels. No doubt. Okay. Everyone note down these points. Okay, these are the protocols which we are going to discuss. Yeah, so now here when we are going to look at that, see, The stop and go protocol gives us an idea of how to add flow control to its predecessor. Okay, means I am stopping that until and unless. See, in the stop and wait, what happened? I have sent a frame, then I am waiting for the receiver, whether receiver is received it or not. I am not simply dumping the everything to the receiver. Okay, so now, but as I told in the previous class, whether we are going to have the noiseless channels. Noiseless channels are very difficult to the existent, non-existent. See, here you have to keep it in your mind that so non-existence, noiseless channels are non-existent. Means most of the times you are going to have noisy channels only. Most of the time you are going to find noisy channels only. So in that particular situation, anything can happen, as I have told you that. Okay. So the acknowledgement is not received, or the frame is not reached, or in that case, how we are going to do that? So we are going to have three techniques. What are those three techniques? Stop and wait ARQ, okay. Automatic repeat request, go back in automatic repeat request, selective repeat, automatic repeat request. Now this ARR, automatic repeat request, you can mention it as ARQ also. What you can use? ARQ. Okay, so dear friends, now we are going to look at the first one, stop and wait automatic protocol. Okay, so ARQ technique. Now what it is going to be happen, it has to check whether error connection in stop and wait ARQ is done by keeping a copy of the sent frame and retransmitting of the frame when the timer expires. Now you imagine, as here I have shown to you people that like this. Now it is sent a frame, okay, then it is waiting. So receiver has to send, it should send the acknowledgement. Now you see, this is the time which is going to wait after sending for a frame. Now you imagine it is not getting the acknowledgement. It is not getting the acknowledgement. What it should do? What it should do? If it is not receiving the acknowledgement, after a specific time, it should retransmit the frame. Whenever the timeout will occur, so what it should do? It should retransmit and wait for the acknowledgement. Okay, you will ask that, sir, how many times it is going to wait, sir? Now, if suppose I am going to take this K as a counter, okay, so maximum 15 times it is going to do like that. 15 times, whenever the time is going to expire, it is going to resend at all. Okay, anyhow, this we will discuss now. Okay, so now if it has to retransmit for this particular purpose, what it require? If suppose it is sending a frame one, if it is sending a frame one, so previous case never I have told that it should keep a copy of frame one, okay, because it is a noiseless channel. But now it is a noiseless channel, whatever it is going to send, it should retain a copy. Now it should retain the copy up to what time? Up to receiving of this correct acknowledgement. So now it has sent F1, now it is not received the acknowledgement, then after the timeout this frame has to be retransmitted. Now here you please look at that. Stop and wait ARQ is done by keeping a copy of the sent frame, okay, and retransmitting of the frame when the timer expires. This is what we are going to talk about, the stop and wait ARQ. Now here you can have a look at. So then another important point when we are going to look at the stop and wait ARQ, okay, now we use the sequence numbers. As I told that here F1, I mentioned F1. If suppose in the previous case I have told like this, okay, F, only F and acknowledgement, then F, then acknowledgement. Now here if you are going to look at that, see, we have not used any numbers over here, frame, frame, acknowledgement, acknowledgement. But now what is going to be happen? So here for the sequence purpose, what we are going to do in the sense, we use sequence numbers to the number the frame, to number the frames. That is what exactly we are going to say, F1, F2, F3, like that. So these sequence numbers are based on modulo 2 arithmetic. Okay, you remember that. Now then another one, when I'm using the frame one, like when I'm using F1, when I'm using F2, okay, so when I'm using F3, like this, when I'm using the numbers, same way, I need acknowledgement for one, acknowledgement for two, okay. So now for acknowledgement also, we need to use that particular thing, okay. So now here, that is the reason, acknowledgement number also we are going to use.
Hello, sir, good morning, sir. Class, sir, I'll call you back. 11:30, sir. 11:30, sir.
So in the stop and wait ARQ, the acknowledgement number always announces in modulo arithmetic and the sequence number of the next frame expected. Now here, if you are acknowledging F1, then you should keep acknowledgement 2. What you have to write? Acknowledgement 2. So here you have to write acknowledgement 3. Okay, if you are going to have F0, what I have written is correct. If it is F0, then what I should write? So okay, if F0 is there, now next frame, what it should send? It should send 1. So when I am going to write acknowledgement 1, this indicates that received F0 up to F0 correctly, expecting F1, expecting frame 1. Now, for this F1, you need to send, whenever you have sent the F1, for that it should send the acknowledgement 2. That is what exactly? The next frame which is going to be expected. So when F1 is received, it should send acknowledgement 2. Acknowledgement 2 is nothing but 1 I have received perfectly. Now I am expecting 2. This is what exactly you have to understand over here, dear friends. Acknowledgement always is going to contain acknowledgement of the current frame plus 1. So that is the next frame expected. Now, the design of the ARQ protocol, please note down. Easily you can understand. Stop and wait ARQ protocol. Once if you will note down, then I will explain the correct means, because I have to move the slide, no? So that was the reason. So please, I'm requesting everyone. So if you can note down this, then we will have that. Now here, if you are going to look at that, next frame to send 0, 1, 0, 1, stop and wait. This is the counter which we are going to use like a can send. Okay, you will come to know that. Now here we are going to use the sequence number, data frame, frame number we are going to keep it. And this is the acknowledgement frame which we are going to use, okay, over here. So this is at the sender side SN, and this is the receiver side RN, which we are going to use it. So once the sender has to send one frame, and then this is a stop and wait. In the stop and wait, one frame has to be sent, and then it should wait for the acknowledgement. Okay. Now, how it is going to be happen? Now here, if you look at that, this is a noisy channel. Everyone should remember. In this noisy channel, okay, shall I explain the algorithm? Either you can take a snapshot, either you can note down. Shall I explain?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so dear friends, once if you are going to look at that, only in the noisy channel, what is going to be happen? Either sometimes whatever the frame you have sent, this frame is not reached to the receiver. Now, sender does not know, okay, what has happened? It has sent a frame. It is waiting for what? Acknowledgement. Whether this frame is reached to the destination? Tell me, whether this frame is reached to the destination? No. When the frame is not reached to the destination, how the destination can send the acknowledgement for it? How the destination, how the receiver can send the acknowledgement for it? So now, how much time it should wait? It should wait for a specific time, okay, to receive the acknowledgement. See, this is sometimes it is going to be happen whenever your parents are going to request you to get something from the nearest shop. They will wait for some time, okay? After that some time also, if you are not going to come, they will wait for another some time. Then also, if you are not going to come, then what is going to be happen? The panic situation arises, where you have gone, what happened and all, then that is going to be like that. What I mean to say in the sense, for everything, whenever I have sent it, to receive that acknowledgement, I need some minimum time. So I will wait that much time. So within that much time, if I'm not going to get an acknowledgement, what I should do, I should resend this frame again. This is the one case. Second case, you please see, whatever the frame I have sent it, it is reached correctly and receiver has sent the acknowledgement, now in this case, what happened? Acknowledgement is not reached to the sender. Now anyone can tell me what sender has to do? When sender is waiting for some time, and if it is waiting for the acknowledgement, and that acknowledgement is lost during the transmission, then what sender has to do? Am I audible? Dear students, I am asking a question to you people. Sandeep?
Yes, sir.
What is going to be happen in this case?
So, sender should send, it should verify that the connection still exists or no.
Connection is there. See, it is not received the acknowledgement. What it has to do? Quite simply, it has to resend the frame.
Okay, sir.
It should resend the frame. If this acknowledgement is not coming to that, it should wait for some certain amount of time. Once if this time is out, then what it should do? It should retransfer the frame and wait for the acknowledgement again. But here, what is going to be happen? Already this frame is received by the receiver. Now, what is going to be happen? Receiver is going to get a... What is going to be happen at receiver end? Duplicate packet is going to be arrived, because already it is received it. But here the acknowledgement is not reached the destination, sorry, sender. So sender is going to retransmit it. Now in this case, now the second question is receiver, how it is going to handle the duplicates? How it is going to handle the duplicates? Then, now the question, what is going to be happen? Now you see, now if frame is lost, is one question. If acknowledgement is lost, another question. Frame is not lost, but frame is arrived in error. Frame is arrived in error, then what is going to be happen? When this is going to send the acknowledgement, it is going to send the acknowledgement whenever the received frame is correct. Do you accept? Whenever I have received the data correctly, then only I have to send the acknowledgement. Now, if a frame is reached the destination, but it is not, see, I have told that frame is not reached. Second, I have told that acknowledgement is not reached. Now, third, I am telling that frame is reached, but error. Now, these are the cases which you have to encounter in the noisy channel. In the noisy channel, whenever your channel is a noisy, now all these things you have to take care. Now, if you are going to look at, dear friends, the algorithm, okay? Now here you can have a look at. Now here, sender side, what we are going to do. So initially you are going to keep your SNS 0, the sequence number. See, that is nothing but your frame number. Okay, now here you are going to keep your frame numbers as a binary, either 0 or 1. That was the reason Now here you are looking at the sequence number, your frame number says either 0 or 1 0 or 1, and you received the 0 or 1. Okay, now the point is you are going to send acknowledgement 1, acknowledgement 0, like that only. Okay, so now here, so frame 0 should be the first one which you are going to send it if you are going to keep SN as 0. Actually can send is true. I'm making the first frame to send, first request to grow. Now here, whenever the wait for event is there, whenever the network layer is ready to send the data, it should take the request to data, and whenever the can send is true, can send is true, what it should do, it should take the get data, then it should make a frame for SN. What is SN? 0. And it should store the frame, as I told that over here, you see, it should store the frame, keeping a copy of the frame. So that was the reason, store the frame, then send the frame, then start the timer. You have to start the timer. And how much time it should write? See, you are going to estimate a round trip time, round trip time. You're going to keep that much time in this. Then what you are going to do, you will say SN is equal to SN plus 1. Okay. And then can send is equal to false. You are going to move the SN pointer to 1, and then you are making the can send is false, so that, so receiver has sent it and it has kept a copy, and now it has sent the frame, it was started the timer. Now we will go to the receiver side. What receiver side is going to do? Receiver side, it should get the first frame. Frame 0 is expected. So whenever the arrival notification is there, receive the frame. Now it should check whether it is corrupted or not. Whether, if it is receiving the frame, it has to check whether the received frame is correct or not. Okay, now you imagine if the received frame is corrupted, then what you have to do? Keep it asleep. Now what sleep is going to do? Your sleep is going to sleep until your timer expires. So your receiver is not sending acknowledgement. If receiver is not sending the acknowledgement, sender will never get the acknowledgement. So the timer is going to wait for some certain amount of time. After that, the timer is going to out. Then it has to retransmit. Now this is of a case one. Then if the received sequence number is correct, okay, if the received frame is correct, not corrupted, then what I should do? I have to verify the sequence number of the received frame and whatever I am expecting, okay, whether these two are same or not. If these two are equal, extract the data, deliver the data to the network layer and increase the pointer, and then send frame RN. See, now RN is not 0, RN is 1. Now the point is, I am sending acknowledgement one for to the sender. Now when I'm sending the acknowledgement for R1, now that, what is the meaning of that? I have successfully received frame zero. Now this is what exactly is going to be happen. Now let us consider, if suppose here what is happening, so corrupted frame is there, it is sleep. Now we will come back to the sender. Now in the sender, now what happened? Now event is timeout. When event is timeout, the timer expired, because there it is sleeping, corrupted frame. So what it should do? Start the timer, then resend SN-1. SN-1 is nothing but what? SN0. SN, see, we have increased the SN over here. So here you need not to decrease the SN, but you are going to keep simply sending the, resend the frame by keeping SN-1. Now if the frame is received correctly and it is sending the frame, now at the sender side, if it is receiving the arrival notification, see, an acknowledgement has arrived. Now what it is going to do? Receive frame, acknowledgement number. And there is another question. Now sometimes acknowledgement may be corrupted. If the acknowledgement is not corrupted and acknowledgement number is equal to SN, then stop timer, purge the frame, then can send, you have to keep it as a true. Can send, make it as a true. Now this is how exactly is going to be happen at that particular things. So any doubts in this? Any doubt in the stop and wait ARQ? Any doubts in the stop and wait ARQ? So here, if I am going to explain with the diagrammatical way, you can have a look at over here. You can understand. See, you have sent the frame 0. It is sending the acknowledgement 1. That is nothing but frame 0 received, correct? When it is sending the frame 1, it is last. Then what is going to happen? Timeout. Whenever the timeout is there, restart and resend the frame 1. Then it is sending the acknowledgement 0. Now it is done. Now acknowledgement is last. Then again it is going to wait for some timeout and it is going to send that frame 0 and it is going to receive the acknowledgement. This diagram definitely you need to draw and you should explain whatever I have explained so far. So any doubts? Any doubts? Dear students, I am asking, okay, no sir, no sir, second, 545, one in, clear sir.
No sir.
Paridhi, yes, Adarsh, good. So today, how many protocols we have checked? Tell me, what are those protocols we have verified? Post in the chat immediately. What are the protocols which we discussed for noiseless first? Type in the chat, what are the noiseless flow control protocols which we discussed? Simplest, stop and wait, 528, very, very good, 551, very good. Here, where is the 3? Stop and wait and this noiseless channel, 513, 1E. Noiseless channel, only 2. Simplest and stop and wait. Okay, now what are the protocols for noisy? For noisy channel, what are the protocols? So for noisy channel, we are going to have 3 protocols. What are those? Amma, 502 Divula, wrong. Simplest to stop, comma, wait protocols, it is not the correct way. See, for noisy channel, we are going to have stop and wait ARQ. Yes, very good. Stop and wait ARQ. 528 again. Sai Harshita, very good. 546. Go back in ARQ. Selective repeat ARQ. Very good. Amma, Shyamala, don't write stop and wait. You have to write stop and wait ARQ for noisy channel. Compulsory ARQ. 546. Shyamala. Thanks for acknowledging. Now you see, Shyamala was acknowledged. I have received it. Otherwise, I should resend. Yeah, Divula 502, you are mentioned for noiseless channel. Francis, you have mentioned for noiseless channel. Very good. Okay. So now this is what exactly you have to understand. So in the noisy channels, and that, see, the various things when you are going to look at in the noiseless channels, sorry, in the noisy channels, frame last or corrupted frame, okay, last acknowledgement or corrupted acknowledgement. Okay, so these are the things which we have to keep it in our mind, dear friends. Always we should keep these things in our mind. Okay, so this is what exactly we should understand. Okay, some examples are given. So then we will look at the next example of go back n and all. So that we will discuss in tomorrow's class. We will discuss in tomorrow's class that. So I hope you have understood all these algorithms. So thank you for attending the class. Money.